Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshu Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 2nd of June. India's health minister bats for patent waiver for COVID vaccines. NATO will continue civilian diplomatic presence in Kabul, says Stoltenberg. And disaster feared as chemical cargo ship sinks off Sri Lanka. And now for all the details. India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Wednesday said that there is no scope for industries to stick to intellectual property rights of COVID-19 vaccines and that organizations must find ways to ensure affordable access to key drugs. His remarks came a day after foreign ministers of India and South Africa discussed with their BRICS counterparts the need for patent waiver to make it easier for developing countries to produce or import COVID-19 drugs.
India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Wednesday said that there is no scope for industries to stick to IPR, intellectual property rights of COVID-19 vaccines, and that organizations must find ways to ensure affordable access to key drugs. Speaking at the 149th session of WHO's executive board, Harshvardhan said in such a dire global crisis, both risk management and mitigation require further strengthening of global partnerships to rekindle interest and investment in global public health.
At a critical time like the present pandemic, there is no scope for industry to stick to intellectual property rights. Sometimes we find that there is little willingness for collaborative research. Affordability too is a key driving factor to achieve our aim of health for all.
The Indian Health Minister's remarks came a day after India and South Africa, during a BRICS Foreign Ministers Summit, discussed the need for temporary waiver of trade-related aspects of intellectual property rights to address the global gap of vaccine access. India's tally of infections on Wednesday stood at 28.3 million, while the death toll reached 335,102. The South Asian nation has administered about 212 million doses, but has given the necessary two doses to only about 3% of its 1.35 billion people. The Indian government had earlier this week said that the country will have nearly 120 million doses available for domestic use in the month of June, in a boost to its immunization campaign that has been marred by shortages of jabs.
NATO defense ministers met virtually on Tuesday to discuss the way forward in Afghanistan, following which Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said the alliance will continue its civilian diplomatic presence in Kabul to provide advice and capacity building support to Afghan security institutions as the US and coalition forces have started troops withdrawal from Afghanistan. NATO will continue to support Afghanistan security forces even after the planned withdrawal this year of the alliance's 9,600 troops, and its civilian presence in capital Kabul will be maintained to provide advice to security institutions, Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said on Tuesday. He made the remarks following the meeting of the NATO North Atlantic Council and Defense Ministers session on Tuesday, in which they discussed the alliance's future role in Afghanistan. Last month, NATO said it would withdraw its forces from Afghanistan this year, despite fears that the Taliban could regain power.
We are ending our military mission, but we are not ending our support to the Afghans. So today, defense ministers discussed the way forward. We will continue our civilian diplomatic presence in Kabul to provide advice and capacity building support to Afghan security institutions.
The Pentagon Central Command said on Tuesday that it has already completed up to 44% of the U.S. withdrawal. U.S. President Joe Biden has set September 11 as the deadline for all U.S. personnel to be out of Afghanistan, officially ending America's longest war. Meanwhile, Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi on Tuesday called for the reduction in violence in Afghanistan in order to bring a ceasefire between the warring sides, the Taliban and Afghan government, as he met Speaker of Volesi Jirga, the lower house, Mir Rahman Rahmani. With another round of intra-Afghan talks scheduled to begin in next couple of days, Pakistan does not seem hopeful of a breakthrough, reinforcing its worry about a security vacuum in Afghanistan after pullout by United States. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Democratic Movement Chief Maulana Fazlul Rahman has said that those disembarking the train mistakenly must reconsider the decision in a reference to Pakistan People's Party and Awami National Party leaving the opposition alliance. He said PDM's target is to oust Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government and not those leaving the alliance.
Pakistan Democratic Movement or PDM President Maulana Fazlur Rahman said on Tuesday that those disembarking the train mistakenly must reconsider their decision in a reference to PPP, the Pakistan People's Party, and ANP, the Awami National Party, leaving the opposition alliance. Rahman, while speaking to reporters, said that PDM's target is ousting the illegitimate and corrupt government of Prime Minister Imran Khan, and those leaving the PDM are not their target. He announced that the alliance will start a fresh round of anti-government protests in July.
ये सफर है और सफर में कोई सवारी उतरती है कोई चढ़ जाती है लेकिन सफर नहीं रुकता सफर अपनी जगह पर बरकरार रहता है हम तो अब भी समझते हैं कि जो दोस्त गलती करके इस गाड़ी से उतरे हैं उनको नजरसानी कर लेनी चाहिए हमने तो कोई सख्त रवैया नहीं इख्तियार किया
Rahman's remarks came after PPP chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari earlier this week said there is no point rejoining the PDM while it has no action plan. The PPP and the Awami National Party had parted ways with the PDM in March over differences on appointment of the leader of opposition in the Senate.
Moving on, persons with disabilities held a protest recently in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan to demand benefits of government schemes and jobs. They blamed, while the successive governments have failed to provide them employment, they are also kept bereft of income support programs for their welfare, highlighting rampant corruption.
Persons with disabilities staged a demonstration recently in Gilgit-Baltistan alleging discrimination in government schemes and jobs. The protesters, who were joined by locals, blamed, while the government has failed to provide them employment opportunities, despite quota reserved for them, they are also kept bereft of benefits of income support programs for their welfare, highlighting rampant corruption in the illegally occupied region.
कि खैरात जो आई है उस पर भी डाका डाल रहे हैं यानी बेशर्मी की कोई हद ही होती है तो इन स्पेशल लोगों को जब तक आप नौकरी नहीं देते हैं इनको रोजगार नहीं देते हैं तो सोशल वेलफेयर फंड में तो इनको शामिल रखो ना यार इतनी तो आपको शर्म आनी चाहिए ना
Despite several demonstrations to demand their basic rights, authorities continue to ignore the plight of the specially abled persons. Activists claim that this is because Pakistan, which controls the Stooge government in the region, treats Gilgit-Baltistan as its colony and denies fundamental rights to locals with no honour accorded to them.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The Nepal government has decided to vaccinate people in the age bracket of 60 to 65 from June 8, as 800,000 doses of vaccines provided by China to Nepal on grant have arrived in the country. Nepal, currently with a population of 850,000 within the age of 60 and 64, will start inoculating them from June 8 onwards as the country battles one of the highest COVID-19 viral reproduction rates in the world. The Nepalese Minister for Health and Population, Hridaya Tripathi, said people will be inoculated as and when the vaccines arrive, indicating that there is possibility of importing additional vaccines from China and the United States in the immediate future. Earlier, those above 65 years of age were vaccinated in 63 districts and those above 55 years of age in 14 districts. Nepal had suspended its vaccination program after it ran out of doses. Initially, India donated about 1 million doses of AstraZeneca vaccine and Nepal secured doses from the global vaccine sharing program COVAX from China. Officials in Nepal say altogether 2.1 million people have had the vaccine and out of that number, 400,000 have received both doses. Meanwhile, Nepal's COVID-19 toll on Wednesday reached 566,587 with 7,454 deaths. Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lankan authorities on Wednesday said the cargo ship carrying tons of chemicals is sinking off its west coast in one of the country's worst ever marine disasters. Salvage experts were attempting to tow the fire-stricken container ship that had been loaded with chemicals into the deep sea as the vessel started to sink off Sri Lanka's main port.
A cargo ship carrying tons of chemicals is sinking off Sri Lanka's west coast, the country's government and Navy said on Wednesday in one of Sri Lanka's worst ever marine disasters. The Singapore-registered MV Express Pearl carrying 1,486 containers, including 25 tons of nitric acid along with other chemicals and cosmetics, was anchored off the island's west coast when a fire erupted on May 20. Authorities had been battling the blaze since then, with flaming containers laden with chemicals falling from the ship's deck, the Navy had said. It was extinguished on Tuesday. Taking to Twitter, State Minister of Fisheries Kanchana Vijayasekara said, the sinking vessel Express Pearl is being towed away to deep waters by the salvage company with the support of the Navy and other stakeholders involved. Tons of plastic pellets have swamped the island's coastline and rich fishing grounds, creating one of the biggest environmental crises faced in decades, experts say. The government has banned fishing along an 80-kilometer stretch of coast, affecting 5,600 fishing boats, while hundreds of soldiers have been deployed to clean the beach.
Members of LGBTQ community celebrated the Pride Month in India's southern Chennai city on Tuesday by distributing masks and hoisting the rainbow flag amid the coronavirus pandemic. Pride Month is celebrated in honor of community members who have been through various obstacles in life and have come a long way. Pride Month is celebrated in honor of community members who have been through various obstacles in life and have come a long way. This year, due to the ongoing pandemic, members of the community in southern Chennai city celebrated Pride Month by distributing masks and hoisting the rainbow flag, adhering to all standard COVID protocols.
LGBT people ka June month bahut celebrate karne ka month. Gaye saal bhi hamare waste kya bhi karne nahi hua, kahin ke liye pandemic desh mein kuch bhi nahi karne hua, celebration nahi karne hua. लॉकडाउन पूरा था लेकिन पहला बार हमको कोरोना पूरा नवा दिखा, इसके लिए हम कुछ भी नहीं कर सके. ये साल हम जो करना हमारा मन नहीं छोड़ना के लिए ये बात थोड़ा से बहुत सब लोग सोशल डिस्टेंस रख के बाद में मास्क पहन के सिर्फ हम सेलिब्रेट कर रहे हैं.
As Pride Month is very significant month for the LGBTQ community, members of the community said it was important for them to raise the rainbow flag as it is central to their identity politics.
And people who are in the fringes, people who are not very privileged in society, we are pushed to a greater link than the others. So in that sense, I think these are very small ways in which we resist. We resist the push of the pandemic.
In India, the Supreme Court in 2018 struck down Section 377, a colonial-era law that outlawed same-sex relations, sparking hopes of equality for the country's lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender population. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.